I specialize in cognitive behavioral therapy for insomnia, otherwise known as CBTI. I also do a lot of bright light therapy for patients with circadian rhythm disorders. Our practice for insomnia treatment is different than other practitioners' offices because we do a lot more with circadian rhythm manipulation. A lot of patients with insomnia need CBTI, but they have often a misalignment of their biological sleep clock, and other doctors don't often pay attention to that, so we use bright light therapy to shift their clock accordingly, and often that resolves the problem. There haven't been a lot of technological advances over the past 10 years for insomnia treatment per se. A lot of the therapies are pretty standard. However, one major advance was that in 2018, the American College of Physicians formally recognized CBTI, a non-medical therapy, as the first line approach for insomnia treatment versus sleeping pills. To be part of Scripps is very gratifying. I'm working with some exceptional doctors in my field. The way we collaborate and share different perspectives on different sleep disordered cases, I think offers a lot of richness to the options for care, which patients might not get elsewhere. When patients come to see me for care, what they can expect is a lot of attention to individual needs and conditions. So for example, often with cognitive behavioral therapy for insomnia, it's often kind of a one-size-fits-all programmatic approach. I try to take into account individual issues, lifestyle concerns, medical conditions, psychiatric issues, and really try to tailor the therapy to the individual as opposed to a programmatic, a step-by-step approach. I want them to know that I will really listen to what they're trying to tell me about how they're sleeping and how it's impacting the quality of their life. Sleep is a very fundamental behavior for humans, and it kind of sets the tone for our waking lives. And I think it's very important to understand that the way in which a person's sleep pattern at night is impacting their waking life, and not just addressing the sleep component, but also the waking experience.